I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today I'm doing a roast turkey breast. Now, I did roast turkey for Thanksgiving, and that was to feed a lot of people. It was a 12-pound turkey, and we showed you how to carve it so you could serve it nicely for your large family gathering. Some of you don't need a turkey that large, and I decided to go with the turkey breast because some of you may like just the white meat. So this is going to be a little different. I have a turkey breast here, and you can see it's this is honeysuckle white, extra tender and juicy turkey breast. It's an 8-pound turkey breast, so we'll be cutting into that in just a minute. All right, let's go over here to the sink because this is kind of the messy part. I'm going to use some kitchen shears to cut through this netting, and then I'll need to cut where this is clamped together with a metal piece. And this takes me a while, so let me just go ahead and do that, and I'll come back, and I'm going to show you the washing of the turkey. I didn't show that last time, and some people were curious about washing the turkey, so we'll come back and do that. Now, this was a frozen turkey, and I've had it in the refrigerator for the last 3.5 days, and it's taken about that long for it to thaw out, even though that's about the length of time, I think 4 days, I used on the 12-pound turkey. It still had some ice crystals in it, and this probably will too. But I like to get in the sink and actually cut down the side of this, and you see all of that juice that comes out. I like to just let that go down the sink. I'm just going to prop these up here and get this out and let you see what we have. You don't need that juice, and I'll be putting this in the garbage later on, so I'm just going to set it over there. And when we look inside, you're going to see a packet, and you may be thinking, oh, giblets again, or the neck piece. Well, this is different. When you get the turkey breast, what they send you usually is, turkey gravy. So you can follow the instructions there and make turkey gravy, but it will, in my opinion, it's never as good as if you make your own gravy. So I'm going to make an upload following this one that will be of turkey gravy, and I'll try to do it in a different way than I did the turkey gravy that we had for Thanksgiving. Now that was fat-free, and this will be fat-free. But that thickener was cornstarch. This time I'll use flour, and I'll put some milk in it, so it'll be a little creamier. So you can see something different. This is still full of juice, so you need to just let that go. And this is the time when you want to run the water, cold water, cold clear water over your turkey. I have 3 tablespoons of salt of butter out here, which is at room temperature or a little better. I put it in the microwave just now to soften it some, and it did melt a little bit. That's okay. You're just going to be using your hands to put it on there. I have extra butter if I should need to go to that. And then I got out some salt, and I did put that in a container so I could just dip into it and not have to use my hands that have been touching the turkey to go back to my originals. So let's start by putting on some butter. We'll put it inside the cavity, which is pretty dry from the paper towel. So we'll just kind of rub it all the way around inside. We'll do the butter first, and then that will be followed by the salt. So now I'm coming to the outside, and we want to just get it to all parts. If it doesn't cover exactly, completely, it doesn't really matter. You just want a coating of some shortening of some type, and I prefer butter. So now for our salt. I always like to take care of the cavity first. So just go in there and get it salted. Just put what you would normally use if you were salting, say, chicken for frying, or any type of meat. If you're making steak or something that is salted ahead of being cooked, just try to get a nice sprinkling all over. Then I'm going to bring my roasting pan over and pick that up, and then prepare it for the oven. We're almost through with our preparation. It's not hard to make a turkey breast. I have soap right here if you're wondering what I'm doing. I'm just trying to get my hands clean. And I didn't bring a towel over, so I'm back to this washcloth. And here is our turkey pan. And I will have to put it with this side down because it will not balance unless I try to make some kind of makeshift thing to make that work. So it's going to go in like this. But that will be nice because it will have all those juices on the bottom eventually and it will brown up very well. All right, I'm going to bring it over to where my aluminum foil is and show you the way I would cover it. And don't worry that there's not a rack here. Some of you like to cook on a rack, that's fine. I don't feel the need for it. What I want to do is cover this, and I've gotten enough aluminum foil out. I use the long variety. I've gotten enough out that it will go down and cover the sides, including this hump right here. Back up to this. And then I will let it cover the ends as well and crush it in so that I have a pretty tight seal. That will hold all the juices in. If you just lay the aluminum foil over the top and maybe give it a little crunch here and there, a lot of steam will escape, and also there will be a lot of condensation on the inside of this covering, and it will drip down into your oven, and that will not be a pretty sight. So I think we have this crunched down until we have a pretty good seal all the way around. So this is going to make a lovely turkey breast. Let's put it in the oven. I see that it is preheated, and it's going to stay there about 3 1/4 to 3 1/2 hours. And then I'm going to bring it out and show you what it looks like. And then Rick will hopefully carve it for me, and we'll be having it for dinner tonight because my daughter and my son-in-law and my grandson are coming over for dinner expecting turkey. My turkey breast is done, and I'm going to get it out of the oven. It's been 3 1/2 hours. For the last hour, I've been basting it, and you'll notice I have it in a different pan now. 1/2 hour ago, I changed it to be upright so that you could see the top of the breast, and I wanted it browned off, and at that point, it would fit into my smaller roasting pan. So I let it go 1/2 hour to get this nice and brown look. So what I'm going to be doing is moving this out of the roasting pan onto some surface where we can do the carving. So you'll see it in a few minutes carved. So here is our 8-pound roast turkey breast. And what I've done is have Rick do the slicing, which he's very good at, so it's nicely carved. And then I put a little parsley here just to dress it up. And I have put some fresh pears that are chopped up, and I sprinkle them with a little lemon juice to make sure that they preserve well. You might choose another fruit if you like something better. I would like to say that we had portions that did not look as good as this that will be used for soups and stews. There are other portions for the little dog Remy. So I want to wish you a Merry Christmas and good luck with your turkey breast.